Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on current sense amplifiers. My name is Rajni Manchkunda, and I'm a product marketing engineer for Texas Instruments current sense amplifiers. In this video, we will look into the primary factors that impact the choice of shunt resistor and show how to calculate the maximum shunt resistor value for an application. We will also briefly touch upon shunt resistor tolerance error. First, let's define a shunt resistor, or R-shunt. This is the resistor through which load current flows in a current sensing application. Due to Ohm's law, a differential voltage called V-shunt or V-sense is developed across R-shunt, which is then measured by a differential amplifier like a current sense amplifier. Selecting the value of R-shunt is based primarily on two factors, the required accuracy at minimum load current and the power dissipation at maximum load current with its associated size and cost. Now let me explain how to determine minimum current accuracy for a current sensing application. For simplicity, we will only consider the amplifier's offset error in this case and ignore other error sources which will be discussed in later videos. Amplifier input offset voltage, or VOS, is the dominant source of error at low load currents and therefore low sense voltages. The plot on the left shows that offset error decreases as V-sense increases. The larger the voltage developed across the shunt resistor, the more accurate of a measurement can be made due to the fixed nature of VOS. Said another way, this fixed internal amplifier error results in a larger uncertainty as the input signal gets smaller. Let's look at this in some more detail using a theoretical current sense amplifier with VOS equal to 1 millivolt. When V-sense is equal to VOS at 1 millivolt, the uncertainty of measurement is 100%, as shown in the plot and the offset error calculation. When V-sense is increased to 10 millivolts, the measurement error drops significantly to 10%. Now that we understand the dominant constraint at minimum current is due to VOS errors, let's consider what happens at maximum current. On the left is a plot of power dissipation versus shunt resistance for a fixed load current. Power dissipation in the shunt resistor is the product of voltage across it and current flowing through it, or the product of the shunt resistance and square of the current flowing through it. Increasing the value of the current shunt resistor increases the differential voltage developed across the resistor, reducing errors caused by VOS. However, the power that is dissipated across the shunt resistor also increases, which can cause heat, size, and cost problems in a real application. There is a trade-off between maximizing accuracy at minimum current and minimizing power dissipation at maximum current. Consider an application with a minimum current of 1 amp and a maximum current of 10 amps, an R amplifier with VOS equal to 1 millivolt. The red plot shows the variation in the offset error at minimum current versus shunt resistance for this application. The blue plot shows the variation in the power dissipation at maximum current versus shunt resistance. What we can see here is increasing the shunt resistor value improves current accuracy but also increases power dissipation. Decreasing the value of the current shunt resistor reduces the power dissipation requirements but increases the measurement errors. finding the optimal value for the shunt resistor requires factoring both the accuracy requirement of the application and allowable power dissipation into the selection of the resistor. Let's continue working through this example. If a 5 milliohm resistor is chosen for this application, the power dissipation at maximum load current of 10 amps will be about 0.5 watts. And the accuracy at minimum load current of 1 amp will be 20%. If you wanted to improve the minimum current accuracy to 15%, then a shunt resistor of about 6.6 milliohms can be chosen instead. However, this choice will cost us about 0.66 watts of power dissipation at full scale. A higher power dissipation requirement will drive up the size and the cost of the shunt resistor, as I will show later. So there is a trade-off to be made. In this case, 5% less error in exchange for 32% more power dissipation and possible increase of the resistor size and cost. It's up to the circuit designer to determine which is more critical in their application. Increasing the shunt resistor gives us better accuracy, but there is an upper bound for the shunt resistor value. Maximum resistor value in an application depends on these factors: maximum load current to be measured, the full-scale output range of the sensing device, or the full-scale input range of the circuitry after the device, and the gain of the sensing device. The maximum shunt resistor value is calculated as the ratio of the full-scale output voltage of the amplifier divided by its gain, all divided by maximum load current. It should be noted that full-scale output range depends on the device supply and its output swing limitation. So far, we have discussed the sensing amplifier offset error and how it contributes to the overall accuracy of the system. Shunt resistors are not ideal either, and their non-idealities have a significant impact on system accuracy as well. Among the shunt resistor non-idealities, its tolerance is a significant source of error. It is expressed as a percentage and defined as the maximum deviation from the ideal resistance value. The actual resistance can vary by the tolerance amount in both the positive or negative direction. For example, a 10 milliohm, 1% tolerance shunt resistor can measure 10 milliohms plus or minus 0.1 milliohms. That is, it can vary from 9.9 milliohms to 10.1 milliohms. Unlike the amplifier offset error, shunt tolerance error contribution is constant over the entire load current range. Now let's work through a real-world example to better understand what we have discussed so far. In this example, the minimum current is 100 milliamps and the maximum current is 10 amps. We chose the INA199A1 as the current sense amplifier for this application, which has a maximum VOS spec of 150 microvolts. In this example, we will ignore other sources of amplifier error for simplicity. The gain of this device is 50, and the required full-scale output voltage is 5 volts. Using the equations we introduced earlier, the maximum R shunt is calculated to be 10 milliohms. The 10 milliohm shunt resistor will dissipate 1 watt of power at 10 amps, and error due to offset at 100 milliamps of current is 15%. Offset voltage contribution to error at maximum current is 0.15%. But at the full scale input, there are other error sources like amplifier gain error and shunt resistor tolerance error that dominate. Therefore, choosing a resistor with 1% tolerance and given the 1.5% maximum gain error of INA 199A1, the total error at full scale is around 1.8%. Total error is calculated by adding error sources as the root sum of squares, which is discussed in detail in other videos in this series. If the chosen shunt resistor has a tolerance greater than 1.5%, then the tolerance will dominate full-scale error in this case. Here is a table listing unit price for 10 milliohm resistors with different tolerance and power ratings. It can be noted that in general, price goes up with higher power and larger sized resistors. And choosing a higher precision resistor with low tolerance also demands higher price and larger board space. In summary, in this video, we defined the shunt resistor and defined the trade-offs between minimum current accuracy and power dissipation at maximum current. We then discussed how to calculate the maximum value of the shunt resistor for an application. Finally, we briefly touched upon the shunt resistor tolerance error and its effect on system accuracy. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of the content. For more information and videos on current sense amplifiers, please visit ti.com/currentsense.